That's my boy.
Go, boy.
How you doing, boy?
Yeah. Good boy. Hold up. Easy. Easy, boy.
Yep.
Let's see what we got. Whoa, way ahead of me. Must be. Let's go, boy. Thank you.
it's a westerly, so... Or is it an easterly?
Hello again.
Hello. Oh, hello.
How are you, sir?
Morgan, Mr. Morgan.
I'm sorry, my nerves. I'm not quite the outdoor adventurer I thought. This is God's own country, and I feel I'm in purgatory.
I know the feeling.
No, I hope not.
What you trying to take some pictures of, huh? Some more greedy coyotes?
No. Wolves.
Wolves? Now you really are trying to get yourself eaten.
Oh, I hope not. I left the meat over there. I thought I'd be safe, given the wind.
Yeah, sure. If you manage to attract the world's least intelligent wolf.
Well,
I'll stay with you a while. If anything comes, I'll protect you as needed.
You are a gentleman.
Now, you don't know me very well.
Well, to me, you're a gentleman.
You, Willie, I'm worse than the wolves.
You had many dealings with wolves, Mr. Morgan?
Sure.
But you've never been eaten.
Not through man on their part. A while back, I helped a friend from getting devoured. Usually, they are not great fans of man.
I don't blame them.
Me neither. Hey, shh. Here's one. A company.
Yes, yes, there they are. In the trees. Now, don't do anything. I'm going to take a few photographs. Come on. Come on. Hungry boys. Come on. Stay back, stay back. Can't have a man in the frame. They'd think it's staged.
Yeah, sort of is.
Look at them. Magnificent creatures.
Especially when clawing at your eyeballs.
Come on. Stay still, my beauties. Seem to be fans of modern technology.
Is that all of them? We might have kept the wolves from the door.
Entire existence flashed before my eyes.
Yeah, they can be pretty aggressive.
What a way to... Literally a dog's dinner. Still worse things happen at sea.
Do they?
Well, I imagine. Perhaps wolves do better at sea. Are they good swimmers? Well, who knows? You have saved my poor foolish skin once again.
Don't mention it.
Well, I can't begin to repay my debt of gratitude. But no, I am eternally in your debt.
I do, Mr. Mason, I do. You take care now.
And you too, sir.
Just checking this equipment. If only my hands weren't shaking quite so much. First I was scared of cold, but now I'm
be some time working on the mechanism. Good day to you, sir, and Godspeed. The only trophy I need is a photograph, and I hope it catches on. No,
Don't worry about me. Lightning doesn't strike in the same place, and neither do wolves.
Won't take long, boy.
Thank you again. Fare thee well.
You're all right, boy. Hold on. That's my boy.
There you go.
Yeah, here you are, boy. So, you think that photograph will come out?
I can't say with certainty, but I'm hopeful, sir. I'm due some good luck, no?
Carry on like this, I'm not sure you are. Excuse me, pardon. boy.
Would you be interested in some friendly competition? I've come all the way north from Mexico to challenge a real American gunslinger. You him?
Me? A real gunslinger? Let's find out.
Okay, man. That's what I like to hear. Look, man, rules are simple, okay? Whoever shoots more of these bottles wins. The range needs to be clear before we begin, amigo. On a horse, cowboy. Hey, you'll need to get a little closer. Just draw your gun and aim when you're ready, all right? Shoot! Perfecto! Ah, yes! Woohoo! Yes! Ha ha!
All right, feller, you shot a bottle. Don't go filling yourself up on it.
Don't take it too hard. How about we raise the stakes and you try again, huh? Come on. Could win real
right,
big,
let's do
huh?
It.
Aha, that's a good call, amigo. Okay. Whoever shoots four birds out of the sky first, wins. Simple enough? Stand near me, and as soon as they come out, it's anyone's shot. Be patient. Ah! There they go! Shoot! You can shoot, huh? Here it is, okay? Man of my word.
Appreciate it.
Sure. Better watch out next time. You'll see.
mister.
Hello there. Help you?
Just taking a look.
We're with the Appleseed Timber Company. Head foreman. Still getting started on this site, but we should have some fine big valley lumber for sale very soon if you're interested.
I'll keep that in mind.
We should be further along by now, but what can you do? Look at these dolts. Not a brain between them. Listen, you got any supplies for sale? Food? Medicine. I'm starting to run low. I can't spare anyone to go into town. Not the way things are going. I'd be happy to pay premium for them. Appreciate it. That should help keep us going.
I'm leaving. Don't work too hard.
There ain't much danger of that with this bunch, my friend.
Nicely done.
Been a little while, eh? So, buying or selling? Okay, let's take a look at it. Yep.
Howdy.
Welcome back. Clear this ride up for you.
Thanks for your assistance.
Boiled Satan, you scared me.
Boiled Satan? Yeah, I get that a lot. So, what's that you got there?
You ain't interested in no scrap paper. It's nothing. Just something for wiping and sniffing in the night. Yeah. Well, I got to go now.
Hey, why the hurry, partner?
I got a hightail. Don't you follow me now. I don't like people being so close to me.
Thank you. okay, boy? So faster. Look what we got.
This curse is just getting stronger and stronger.
Turning into a bad day for you, mister.
Come on now. You gotta cut me loose.
So, what you got for me?
Oh, come on, you got your map. You'll be rich from it. Enough for a whole night with your favorite sire. Think about it. Hey, you ain't gonna leave me like this.
Tough. Don't mind me. Hey, fellas. I have a meeting with Mrs. Braithwaite. My associates are already here.
All right, that's enough. Move along now.
Please come in, sir. This way, sir. A gentleman to see you, ma'am.
So, your friend, the other liquor vendor. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Arthur, welcome. We were just playing cribbage. Arthur Morgan, Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
Nice to see you again.
Apparently. So this one, he is big and as dumb as he looks?
Well, he's surely big. But his intelligence is a matter of some conjecture. Some say he is as dumb as he looks, but I think, well, he's not quite that dumb.
So these are the boys going to Callagher Hall?
Yes, we can take care of that for you, but one hates to be coarse. There is the question of money.
Oh, we've got money, Mr. Matthews.
Paper, bonds, metal.
She ain't gonna pay you in a certified check, you Yankee numbskull.
Ain't childbirth just the most beautiful miracle?
Well, Arthur.
Seems a lady can birth monkeys, after all.
I drive?
Nope.
All right, let's get this over with.
You was quiet in there.
Took everything I had. That son of a horse. I'll shove that silver spoon down his throat and pull it clean out of his arse. The smug fucker.
Okay. So what she got us doing at the Gray's place?
She wants us to torture tobacco fields. Said they ain't had rain in weeks round here.
What?
Yep. Using that back there.
Moonshine?
Burns faster than kerosene, that stuff. Said it'd be fitting, she did. All I'm thinking is how about my toy fitting my boot up your hook nose, you snotty old bitch.
Jose really picked the right feller for tea at the manor, didn't he?
Ah, he was giving his usual flannin. One of these families got gold stashed somewhere, he reckons. I mean, I'm all for sticking it to rich folks. I hate rich folks. But there really better be some bloody money at the end of all this.
Jose knows what he's doing.
Does he, though? The master finagler of nothing.
Easy, easy.
So far, we've destroyed the Braithwaite still, tried to sell the shine back to them. Now we're on this fool's errand, which I'm very much looking forward to, by the way. They were saying old man Gray's double security after that business at the saloon.
So, we're just gonna drive on in there, is that it?
Don't worry, I got a plan. Wagons go in and out of there all the time with supplies, equipment, payroll. Especially now they're taking on all that extra muscle. We're making a delivery, that's all. Just leave it to me. I can talk a dog off a meat wagon.
All right, then. Yeah.
English.
Excuse me?
You not worried about them Greys?
In what sense?
Well, they knows you.
Yeah, maybe you're right. You know what? Here. I'll go hiding back. If you can act naturally and stop us from getting into a fight before we're ready.
I will try.
Yes. Try and do an impression of a human being.
I'm not going to go that far. I'll do the talking.
Hey, hold him right there.
What you want, boy?
There was a thing at the saloon.
What you talking about?
Well, I'm delivering the supplies.
You're not the usual driver.
You want a bottle, friend? Here. Have a wee drop. I'm new. I mean you no harm. I've come from Donegal in Ireland.
You don't say?
Yeah. They said you'd understand some kind of incident at the saloon in town. I was told to bring this up here. Ask no questions, I'll tell you no lies sort of business. Before the officials got there,
okay.
They said.
Okay. Drive this way. I'll show you how to get there.
Oh, thank you, friend. Have a drink. Sean.
Hamish.
Good to meet you, Hamish. Fine bit of country you've got here. Not as fine as Connemara, but fine nonetheless.
My people come from Scotland.
Is that right? And you and I are nearly brothers.
Just over here. Straight down the path here. It's getting so I can barely keep track of all these deliveries coming in.
Yeah, and they said they was looking for more drivers in town. I jumped at the chance. I ain't never been a feller to kick a bit of honest work out of bed. So, you folks been having a hard time of it, have you?
Yeah, Mr. Gray's got a heap of problems right now with another family around here. Bunch of covetous lowdowns trying to sabotage his livelihood. Disgusting.
Oh, dear, I'm sorry to hear that, Hamish. Sounds like you definitely deserve that drink.
You don't know the half of it. Just in there.
Right there.
You can unload it here.
In here? Oh, the horse is like a swift one, do they?
Excuse me?
Nothing. It's grand. Quite a place you boys have got here. Reminds me of one of them big houses out in Donegal. Huh. Real fancy places they was, Hamish. Real fancy, because if some folks got all the money, they can build quite the fanciest places imaginable, eh?
How you getting on?
Good. Nearly got these things ready.
Okay. There's plenty of guards out there. Here's how I feel we should deal with things. You head over to the dry barn.
Sure. And you?
I'm gonna deal with the fields themselves. We coat everything in moonshine, and then we light things up with these little fellas here. Thankfully, it ain't rained, and that old barn over there should go up like a torch.
How many of these boys you think you need?
It should do it. Let's head out the back. Look, once they get wind of us, there'll be no turning back, so move quickly.
Of course. I'm rebel stock, boy. I was barn burning down manor houses.
We'll burn quietly.
Someone coming on the left.
Ha.
Oh, hey. Well, I thought the wagon already arrived.
This one didn't.
Strange. So, what you got there?
Tools, payroll.
Okay. Drop it by the supply shed at the back of the fields.
Sure. See you later.
You hear that? Payroll.
Yeah. Let's get this job done first, okay?
I'll take care of this fella. Come on. You douse the fields. I'll meet you at the barn.
Try to stay out of trouble.
Good.
gonna douse this too. Must have something with a flame, right? I'll give you 4 stars. Would you look at that? Now let's go light ourselves a fat cigar.
Somebody shoot him already!
We'll deal with these fellas. You keep warning.
I got the ray head!
Not right now. We got company. Look out!
Stay with me!
This is a goddamn mess.
Money's worth, darling.
Let's just get out of here first.
I think we lost them.
Yeah, we did.
Quite a night.
Sure.
Interesting little fight Dutch has put us into the middle of here.
I
hope him and Jose are right and that there's some money at the end of it.
What now?
Head on back to camp.
You coming?
Sure.
Tobacco?
I'm busting for a smoke.
You did good with that Graves business.
Like I told you, I was born and down Manor House.
Pearson.
Hello, Arthur.
Arthur.